Friends, welcome on this video. Daniel is here from Tips to Fix, and today, in this video tutorial, we are going to do something cool, guys. So as you already know, 25H2 of Windows 11, it's released, it's stable version, you saw my earlier videos. I'm happy for all of you guys, thank you for comments that you do on my videos, and you are amazing, all of you guys are amazing. Thank you for commenting, thank you for supporting the channel, thank you for helping each other, thank you for commenting, I love you guys. Today, in this video tutorial, we are going to test 25H2 on old unsupported computers. I mean, when I say old, the processors that don't support SSE4.2 or POPCNT, these are two new requirements that Microsoft require enable for Windows 11 to work with the new coding that they are doing. And what I did today, before you do an upgrade and before you crash your computer or before you test your computer and maybe you are afraid, I did this video to show you exactly what will happen if you install. Let's see together, guys, if this method it will work. In the moment that I record this video, I didn't know if it will work or not. So, when I tested, is the real thing. Okay, I don't want to lose your time. Let's go directly to the point. Let's try installing and let's see if it will work. Okay, guys, are you ready? Let's try to this computer, really unsupported for Windows 11, 25H2. 24H2, we was not able to install on this processor at all because does not support SSE4.2 and also POPCNT. Look, this computer is Core 2 Quad, Core 2 Duo, Core 2 Quad is the same architecture. There is no SSE4.2 for this computer. I'm on Windows 10 Pro here, 22H2. Let's try to install Windows 11 25H2. Let's try to upgrade if this will work or not. I will use my script that I created. Let's go download Windows 11. We need to have here the latest version, 25H2. We will try today to do the impossible possible if it's possible. So the Windows language that I wanted to download is the one that is the same with your Windows 10. If you are on Australia or United Kingdom or Canada, you need English International. I'm going to download PCL check. Okay. ISO is downloaded. Let's bring it in here on desktop. What is punishing us on installing or upgrading to the latest Windows 11? Check your computer. Okay. This PC must support secure boot. The processor isn't currently supported. TPM 2.0 must be supported. Okay. So we have a lot of requirements that our computer is not able to do it, okay? Now, what I'm going to do, let's try my script. Go ahead, download it. We'll bring it here on desktop. Let's do with this, extract. I'm going to drag in desktop. Here is my script. Just double click, run as administrator. Continue. SSE4.2 not supported, POPCNT not supported. Do you want to continue? Yes. Fast install. Let's try with fast install. What do you think? Let's do it. Let's try with fast install. Downloads. Here it is, the latest version. Now it's extracting. Yes, yes. It's creating a new folder here at desktop. And it's extracting the ISO. It's bringing ISO here. It will take a little. It's extracting, like copy and paste, but this computer is not that fast. Let's see here, my drive. Performance. Nah, look at this SSD is 100% working. 100% working. So my SSD drive here, it's working on extreme mode now. We need to give some time. Extraction is done. Okay, here it is. Install Windows Server. Change the tab downloads. We don't need any downloads. Click next here. Let's see, guys. Let's see if we are able to bypass the requirements. Look at this. Accept. Choose what to keep. Guys. What? We skip everything? Okay. Keep files and settings. I'm upgrading, guys. It looks like it's working. Let's see if this really works. I will be amazed. Okay, it's saying install Windows 11 Pro, keep files and settings and apps. Okay. Guys, let's hit install and let's see. Okay, the installing process is 11% complete. Let's click here, Task Manager, because I wanted to be sincere with you guys, and you will see the processor that I'm installing. Core to Quad, I'm showing these guys because I wanted to be very, very sincere, very clear with you. I don't want you to think that I'm trying to install on another computer or something. Look at this. This PC doesn't currently meet the requirements completely. Processor is not supported, TPM not installed, not enabled. Okay. So this is the moment, guys. Your PC will restart in a few moments, okay? Here it is. Working on updates. Don't turn off your computer. But how it says working on updates and didn't do the restart? You think it will work? Let's see, guys. 30% now restarting. You see, guys, before we was not able to bypass these requirements from the beginning. I mean, 24H2, we were trying to bypass these steps and we didn't. It was super impossible. First step was done successfully, but let's see when computer reboot. Interesting, I'm on this Dell Optiplex 780 series. Let's see. Waiting. What? You think it end up in this loop? You think it's corrupted? Windows is corrupted? I think it's going back. Let's see what is going on. It's protecting itself, I think. What is going on here? Spinning around, spinning, spinning, spinning. I told you. So you see, we are back on Windows 10. We couldn't install Windows Server, Windows 11 25H2, because of this error. The installation failed in the safe OS phase with an error during boot operation. You know why is that? It's because Windows 11 25H2 is based on this requirement. So this requirement, POPCNT and SSE4.2, is everywhere spread on the Windows 11 setup. It's the same thing like in 24H2. So guys, don't try to upgrade your old CPU that does not support POPCNT and SSE4.2, okay? So don't try. If you're lucky enough, you will get back in Windows 10 like my computer did, but in most cases your computer will not boot anymore. So please don't try to install on your very old computer. Okay guys, you see it by yourself, doesn't work. 25H2 on very old computers that require SSE4.2 is critical for Windows 11 latest versions, 24 or 25H2 or maybe next generation's Windows 12. Waiting for Windows 12. If you're still in this computer, very old computer, 2010 on Core 2 Duo or Core 2 Quad processor, they will perform great. If you put SSD, if you put more RAM, do it on the maximum hardware possible. I suggest you guys keep Windows 10 Pro or Home Edition, whatever, and enroll for 1 year more security update. See the other video tutorial that I did for this topic, how to enroll for Windows 10 security updates offered by Microsoft. There are three options. so including free. But if you want to have Windows 11 on this computer, try with 23H2. I mean, 23H2 is good. It will end support in November, yeah, I know. But if you like to keep it and try, give it a try, not for long term. Everybody uses internet, okay, to see things online, and you know, I know you like to navigate. But if you are careful online, you can keep without security updates as long as you are not going on bad websites or websites that give you things and scripts and downloading. And you know, if you keep your computer for documents, for work, and if you have a good antivirus in your computer, it will protect you, okay? I did another video tutorial, guys, how to keep your computer secure, some cybersecurity tricks. I did the video for that. Okay, go ahead and watch it. For you guys that have processor generation 7, 5, 4, 6, and you wanted to have Windows 11 on your computer, latest version, go ahead, watch the other video tutorial. It's great. Everybody is watching. The method is safe. It's based on Microsoft requirements, and without any problem, you can install it. Another thing, to have Windows 11 on your super old computer using Tiny 11. Yeah, I know, I didn't do video tutorial for that. I'm going to do a video tutorial how to install Tiny 11. Why not? Stay tuned, guys. Keep watching Tips to Fix, okay? Please subscribe my channel. I see, guys, that a lot of you are watching the videos, but most of you didn't hit that button, subscribe. I need that. We need to be together. I have to do more videos. I'm going to fix your problems. Also, if you have any problem on your computer or headphones or everything, so you know, I have a lot of videos in my channel. Write me a comment, tell me your problem. I will try to fix it, okay? Don't forget that, as always, God loves you, and may God bless you, guys. See you on the next video.